you can use Amazon Web Services to store your data for annotation and to load images from AWS directly into CVAT. Once the annotation process is complete, you can seamlessly export the annotated data back to the AWS service. In CVAT, you can access all the storages from the Cloud Storages page. Now, let's switch to AWS, where we have created an account, added a bucket, and loaded images. To connect AWS Cloud Storage to CVAT.ai, we need to create a user and add it to the group. To begin, click on Create User and provide a name for the new user. The next step is to create a group. For more details, please refer to the documentation link in the video description. After creating the user, you'll need to obtain the user's security credentials. Navigate to the user's page and click on Create Access Key. Now we are ready to add cloud storage to CVAT and start annotating. Fill in the name field and, optionally, add a description. Proceed to fill in all the other fields as well. Copy the access key ID and secret access key from the user's AWS profile. Add a manifest JSON-L file if you have one and click Submit. The added cloud storage will appear on the Cloud Storages page. Now, let's configure a project that will utilize AWS Cloud Storage as both the source for importing images and the destination for exporting annotated data. Now, let's create a task and import images into this task from the AWS Cloud Storage that we've added. We are going to annotate it to check if everything works fine. After the annotation is completed, you can export the data back to AWS Cloud Storage. In CVAT.ai you can do it in 3 clicks. Open the project page, go to Actions, and select Export Data. Choose the format and enter the name of the exported archive. CVAT will take care of the rest. The annotations were uploaded to the AWS Cloud Storage. That's it for today. Like, subscribe, share. Happy annotating!